say that you're wrestling with, it may not even be your addiction. It may not even be what you enjoy. And 9 times out of 10, what you're hooked up on is not what you enjoy. Somebody introduced you to it, and you thought you liked it. But you do it not because you don't love God. You do it because you don't know your value. You do it because you don't know really what is on the inside of you. You do it because you haven't tapped into your power. You do it because you think that's all that you know. But I stand here today to let you know that the thing that you do, it's not who you are. Just because I told a lie before doesn't make me a liar. Come on, somebody. Just because I've stolen something before doesn't make me a thief. Come on, somebody. Oh my God. Clap your hands tonight. So it's all about territory. Thank God for Jesus, whose purpose for coming to earth was to destroy the works of the devil. This last Adam, Jesus the Christ, restored mankind with both power and dominion. Now that means absolutely nothing to you. Oh my God. Understand that it was the devil who took it from the first Adam, chucked him out of it. But it was the last Adam, Jesus, who gave it back to us. Power and dominion, authority and rulership to speak those things that be not and call them as they are. Oh, somebody needs to understand the power that rests on the inside. And as we are gaining this new ground and new territory, remember that it is new. It is unfamiliar territory. I know we get really excited when somebody says that we've got uncommon favor. But hear me tonight. Hear me. That this type of favor places you in uncharted territory. And there may or may not be a roadmap. Have you ever been in a place that you really didn't know what was going on? Have you ever been in a real place where all you could do was rock steady? This place is full of uncertainties. In this place, it's so easy to begin to murmur and complain. But if I were you, I would run away from anything that was murmuring and complaining. We can so easily misread the signs of what's going on. We can misread what is a blessing as a horrible situation, but it's not personal. Come on, somebody. But this is actually a place to press in and to remind everything around you that for God I live. And for God, please know tonight that every experience has a God-ordained purpose. I know you don't like being misused and being misunderstood, but what you have to know is that it is working for your good. As I have forestated, and I promise you I won't be much longer, we are kings. Matter of fact, Revelation states that we are kings and we are priests. That sounds mighty wonderful. Great responsibility. The word of God says it like this: to whom much is given, much is required. So here we are, people of the Most High. We are kings and priests. Kings and priests must be mature. They've got to be mature leaders. And I know that's an ugly word in the house of God. Sad to say that within the house, it seems like immature. authority runs rampant like an epidemic. I'm not talking about you here. I'm just talking about who I'm talking about.
Preach.
I know we thought the older we get, the more mature we become. But that has not been the case. Many get stuck in their last hell. Many get stuck in immature. In their last trial. Many get stuck in their immaturity. In their last battle. When did the warriors become weak? Somebody help me. Kings and priests don't have the luxury to be weak. Drama every day. Some people wouldn't have a life if drama didn't live with them. But I'm like Mary J.
Please, the one who loves.
spirits and places in the marketplace. When you see the sight of God, they seem to be the one that's the loudest, the hell raiser, the one that's got the nasty attitude, and out of their mouth always is, I'm blessed and highly favored, but they're acting like their daddy. Because listen, if you're hanging out with God, you can't help but have his attribute and the fruit of the spirit. Oh my God.